Hello there. In this video, we are going to take a look at how to take a photograph and then generate an embroidery design that's just a simple filled design that's based on like a silhouette of something in your photograph. So we're going to be using SewArt, a very inexpensive kind of auto-digitizing tool. But in order to get the file that will work really beautifully in SewArt, we're going to be using Inkscape to create that silhouette. So here we go. We will take a look first at Inkscape and then at SewArt Pro, and then we'll show you what the stitched out design will look like.
Hey there. In this video, we are going to create an embroidery file, a filled embroidery file from a based on a photograph, but we're just going to use the silhouette that is kind of dictated by a photograph. So right now I'm working in a program called Inkscape, and this is a free program you can download. And I am going to do my first step here to get my image in a format that's going to be suitable for converting into an embroidery design. So in Inkscape, I'm just going to go to File and then Import, and I am going to import my photograph, and I'm just going to accept the defaults. It doesn't really matter too much, and then I can just drag it into place. Now I probably want to zoom in a little bit, so I can go to the View menu and zoom in. Basically, I want to create this shape that represents the silhouette of the dog head. Now, I have a couple of tools that will allow me to do exactly that. Sorry, I keep grabbing on different things. I'm just going to go with the pencil tool and draw a freehand line. And again, I may want to be a little bit more zoomed in. So I'm just going to zoom in a little bit more and then kind of move that down a little bit. All right, so using my best freehand, I'm going to trace the outline of the dog. And that gets a little wonky right there. And then I'm getting back to the beginning, and Inkscape just fill the shape with a black. That's perfect. That's what I want. But it looks kind of a little bit janky around the edges. So if I go to Path and I say Simplify, and maybe even do it again, Path, Simplify. Ooh, I want to do it even more. Path, Simplify. And then if I want to get into the nitty gritty of really editing this, I can choose this tool right here, which is the Edit Path by Nodes. And I can play with the individual nodes and handles and really kind of get the exact shape that I want. So let's just say I'm happy with it. Then I would say, I don't need this picture anymore. So I'm going to use my selection tool, select that picture, hit delete, and then File, Save As, and I'm going to save this desktop. Nope, not on my desktop. I am going to put it on my removable disk so I know where it is. Here we go. And we will call this doghead.svg. Okay. Next, we will go over to SewArt, and we will say File and Open. And then we will go to our removable drive, and we will find our dog head. And it is great because what's really nice about this is that SewArt thinks of this. It doesn't need to be told what color is what. So if I go to my color palette here, it's already only two colors, so I don't need to reduce it at all. It is a little bit large, so I may want to scale it down a little bit. I want to resize it, and let's say I want it to be no bigger. Let's say I want it to be 2.5 inches wide, and I have the aspect ratio locked, so it will scale accordingly. And then I want to create this as a filled area. So I'm going to go on over to my stitch image and I'm just going to select this area. And now that will be, I can change the angle if I want to. Let's say I want it to be 45. That's going to change the direction of the stitches. I have to do it right here since I already created that embroidery area. Okay. And if I wanted to create an outline too, I could around the border and then select the border. And now I have two different, elements. I have the fill and then I have a stroke going around it. And, so it's going to do all of one first and then all of two. If I don't like this type of running stitch, which is associated, I can make it be like a bean stitch and that'll give it a little bit more weight. So when I'm done designing my embroidery file, I can say file, save as, and now I will save it. Let's put it on my removable disk. And it wants to save it as a TIFF file. That's fine. Every time SewArt does that, it wants to make an image as well, but it's not going to save over that SVG because this is a TIFF file. So we'll say save. And then it's going to, save out my PES file. Save. So if we really, so that looks pretty good. So we can try stitching that out if we want to, but that is how you create a filled embroidery file based on a photograph.